Appearing nightly in the desert, just outside Marfa, the lights are one of the longest-standing, unexplained phenomena in the United States. Explanations run the scale from a UFO landing base to uneasy spirits of long-dead Indians. But one thing is certain, the lights are there. While some people in Marfa would prefer not to talk about these glowing lights, no one will deny they exist. The Chamber of Commerce will be glad to give you directions on how to go about viewing them, and the El Paisano Hotel even conducts a regular tour.
We take people here at the hotel, usually on Saturday night, and we have a scenic route that we take folks on, and part of it's the Marfa Lights. And what we enjoy most that I do is taking people out that don't believe it. When you first start looking at them, you think they're car lights. But when they split up, one jumps this way and one jumps that way, well, it can make a believer out of you real quick.
My experience, when we tried to walk across the desert and catch up with them, it seemed like they always stayed just a few steps ahead of us. We could never get real close to them. So maybe they do possess intelligence. Maybe they do. Maybe they know what we're doing.
Kirby Warnock has been interested in the Marfa Lights ever since he first saw them as a child. He recently spent over a year in research for an article about the lights published in Southwest Airlines magazine. Kirby agreed to be our guide in our quest to learn more about the lights.
Have you ever seen the lights?
Oh, yes, many, many times.
Our first stop was at the home of Mrs. Julia Plumley. Now, her father was one of the first people to report a sighting of the Marfa Lights.
He came out here as 16 years old in 1883. And they unloaded a big herd of cattle at Alpine, which was then Murphyville.
Soon after settling in the Marfa area, the cowboys began seeing lights that they could not explain.
But they believed in the lights.
Oh, they knew it was there. And there wasn't any other lights in those days, you know.
So it couldn't have been car lights or anything like
that's
that?
That's right.
Although the sightings continued through the years, it wasn't until World War II that the lights received much recognition. This is all that remains of what was once home for over 8,000 airmen. The Marfa Army Air Base opened on January 7, 1943, and began training cadets to be bomber pilots.
At that time, there were no yard lights, guard lights, no electricity. Vehicular traffic was at a bare minimum because of wartime restrictions on travel, so any light was conspicuous.
Fritz Kahl was an instructor at the old air base and has been manager of the airport here in Marfa ever since. The Army never released an official statement about the lights, and Fritz says that many of the wild stories from that era were products of some vivid imaginations. But like many of the cadets, he too quickly became interested in the lights.
Socializing with the local citizens, we found out about the Marfa Lights, and we're just like any 21-year-old kid, just intrigued by them. And we would go out and look for them at night when we weren't flying or when we were sitting on night control at auxiliary fields. We'd look for them. We thought we saw them. Then we chased them one night in an airplane. We were pretty badly scared, really. The guy in the back seat said, "You better get out and get the hell out of here. We're right down on the ground," and sure enough, we were.
Fritz's close brush with death didn't end his fascination with the lights, and though he doesn't chase them in planes anymore, he has continued to make sightings over the years. By the time we finished our talk with Fritz, the sun had begun to sink below the horizon, and Kirby said it was time for us to head for the desert. As we left town on one of those long, forlorn stretches of highway that are so common in this part of Texas, the excitement of the search began to grow. So this is Marfa Light Country.
Yeah, we're about 5 or 6 miles out of Marfa right now. And right over there is where the old air base was during the 1940s. And back over that way are the Chianti Mountains, and out there is Mitchell Flats. And that's where we'll see the lights.
We turned off the highway onto the Nopal Ranch Road, location of one of the few reported close encounters with the lights. It was on this road that two oil company geologists encountered two basketball-sized glowing lights that seemed to possess intelligence. Moving at speeds that the geologists estimated to be well over 100 miles per hour, the lights would dart about and hover over the road as if daring the men to try and chase them.
Yeah, this is the spot. We set up right here and start looking out that way toward the Chianitis. When it gets dark, we should see something.
All right, all right.
In the distance, across the Mitchell Flats, lie the Chinati Mountains, playground for the Marfa Lights.
In order to try and record pictures of the lights at night, we're going to use a special instrument called the nightscope.
Developed by the armed forces, the nightscope is capable of greatly amplifying existing light. While it produces a green image, it should allow us to photograph the lights. With all our equipment in place and checked out, and the darkness of the desert falling, we anxiously awaited the light's appearance.
Look at that! Look, look, look! It's just appearing. It's just appearing. I cannot believe it. Now, there's two. There's two. Look.
Popping in and out, sometimes glowing brightly and other times barely visible, the pulsating lights began their nightly show. In the vast open expanses of West Texas, where it's nearly impossible to judge distances, some of the lights appeared to be in the mountains, while others looked as if they were on the desert floor. Some lights would glow brightly and then divide into several lights. We sat and we watched, transfixed for almost 3 hours as the lights played in the distance.
What do the local town folk think of these things?
Well, I think they're very passive about it. And I think one school of thought is to hope nobody ever finds them. They're ours, they're here, we like them, and it's a nice mystery to have. It's a local phenomena. It's not the only one in the world, and it's very pleasant.
Thus ends our tale of the Marfa Lights. If you would like to see them yourself, take Highway 67 between Alpine and Marfa, then park at the Marfa Lights viewing site. Then make up your own mind and decide for yourself.